Welcome to The Medical Conspiracy with Dr. Carpenter.
Good afternoon and welcome back. We are here again to bring you the newest series of events. And has been a really busy, crazy week with a lot of funny things happening. Malarkey. Yeah, a lot of malarkey. A lot of malarkey going on. And as you know, I've used that word on several occasions, but apparently now it's become popular enough to be used in politics and political debates. Okay, so that's how the webmaster picked that one up, my recording. And
it's Irish, too.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah, that's what he said. He says it's an Irish word.
Really, like blimey or something?
Right. Okay. Hey, Orion, how's everybody doing? OrionTalkRadio.com and Micro 1650 in Tonawanda, New York. And everybody listening on Spreaker.com and on Shoutcast. If you're listening on Shoutcast, we have a chat board. It's at MedicalConspiracy.com. And if you just look for the listen button on the top menu, just click listen, and there you go.
Okay. Last week, we closed the show by saying that I ran out of time, but I wanted to discuss the Manuka honey. There is another gate coming up. It's going to be the Manuka gate instead of the Walnut Gate, but it's the same thing, and I promise I will discuss it this week. But another thing I want to say, something else happened this week, and it's connected with the breast cancer. You know, this is October, Breast Cancer Awareness Month, as if we were not all aware of breast cancer, but really what it should be called is Breast Cancer Brainwashing Month. And if you this guy's breaking, he's hammering the TV set because it said about enough of all this.
Pink, but, you see, Pink Floyd, pink.
Yeah. Yeah, but I don't believe they picked the color pink because of Pink Floyd. I think they picked the color pink because usually women like that color. And it was okay until the Common Foundation took hold of that color. Then I just cannot stand the sight of it. Anyway, and there are really weird things going on. But something happened, and I want to discuss it. I'll first discuss the Manuka, and then I'll get into what's happening about a video disappeared on the web about this brainwashing on breast cancer situation. And the brainwashing is apparently effective because this week I went to a store, and I was wearing pink, but it was hot pink, not common pink. And the woman at the cashier said, oh, I like the color. And I said, well, at least it's not common. And the reaction I got is this poor woman believed that the Common Foundation was doing such great work. And I said, what great work? Brainwashing people? And she had no idea what I was talking about. Anyway, it's amazing how people are really not yet aware, realizing what is really going on and what they're being subjected to. So discussing this video that has appeared this week will be great. But before I do that, I want to bring up to light the Common Foundation situation, because not the Common Foundation situation, before the Common Foundation and the brainwashing, and this is the YouTube video, I wanted to discuss the Manuka honey because it's already another disgraceful thing. Now, keep in mind, the Manuka honey is not really directly discussing how they cure cancer, because they don't. But the Manuka honey is work better than an antibiotic in healing wounds, and if not better, just as well, and is not an antibiotic. Yeah.
Not really trolls. Ex-patient turned troll. She was all over the internet a few years ago talking about how she cured herself with that honey.
Well, first, what they did is ridicule me, how I was a quack, did not know what I was talking about, where I advised patients to use Manuka honey. And of course, I was talking about, excuse me, I was talking about using the Manuka honey to help heal the wound faster, because it helps heal wounds. It also helps in a lot of other things, including avoiding resolving the problem of acid reflux, and even before you get to acid reflux, prevent it. So I suggest the use of Manuka honey quite a bit to patients, and they can just go to the website and order it. And of course, they were the trolls were attacking me for saying, you have the tumor out of the skin, it looks like a mess, it's hard to heal, use Manuka honey. And of course, I was a quack because I said that. Then somebody said, the method of Lesmedink didn't work, and then I used my Manuka honey and I cure myself, which is exactly what we said. It's not a curing, it's healing the wound faster. But then they said, no, I never said that. So the whole thing was a complete farce. But this
malarkey.
Okay. But this brings to light.
Gonna wear it out.
Right. But it brings to light what happened to. I recently received an email because I'm on the list of the doctor that prescribe tell patient to use Manuka honey. So they sent me a communication saying that they could nobody could find any longer on their website the scientific information and the evidence of results of how the honey helps. Manuka honey is from New Zealand and is a very pure type of honey. Still honey, still edible, it's still food, but it does other things. And they were saying how they cannot do that because FDA has sent issue warning that they cannot claim a medicinal value of Manuka. And also they have been ordered to remove from their website all their testimonials, which is exactly the same process and the same thing they did to us. They tried to get us to remove the testimonial, and I fought it back really hard because there was no reason for that. And then they say, we want their names. Well, there are some that will talk to you. These are the names, and that's it. Because the testimonial do not give the full name. So I want to protect them, so I didn't give the full name.
Yeah, Michelle wanted addresses and phone numbers.
Yeah, right. Yeah, for their convenience, she would have been really surprised on that one. She would have had another answer. Like that patient told me, you know, I hope you get cancer and face what you're... Anyway, yeah. But that's what they said. And of course, the company is agreeing to it, just like Diamond Food agreed to remove all the information on the benefit of walnuts because FDA was threatening them. And they were told, just in the Manuka honey, the same thing. They were told they had to do all these expensive testing if they wanted to have those claims before, because the moment you say yes, medicinal value, it becomes a drug. One drug, and you have to do the drug testing, which is an abuse, and it's a... You should play that one now. It's a malarkey. Okay? You should have played
malarkey.
Right, it's kind
of malarkey.
But anyway.
Malarkey.
Okay, that's enough.
There you go.
All right, no.
Three times is a charm, you know.
Right, but that's enough. Okay? That makes it six times we have played it. But that's absolutely true. It's not. It's not possible. Food is food. By definition, British dictionary, I can't remember the name. I'll dig out the name of the dictionary that clearly states it so that there are no doubts left. Food is not a drug. It can never be classified as a drug. A drug is a non-food and has to have a physiological effect to be classified as a drug. That's why it needs to be tested, because you don't know what kind of physiological effect can have and what side effect can be connecting with it. But the drugs approved by FDA are not properly tested, if any, at all. Because when they say, oh, we did this and it's wonderful, the results are wonderful, we do not need to do extended testing because He'll be inhumane. Oh, my God. We already have a break coming up. I can't believe how fast the time has gone. Okay.
Glad we heard it, though.
Yeah.
Pink belts.
Clowns to the left of me, jokers to the right. Here I am, stuck in the middle with you. Yes, I'm stuck in the middle with you. And I'm wondering what it is I should do. It's so hard to keep the smile from my face. Losing control, yeah.
Okay, we are back from the first break. And what I was saying before the break, it was about the Manuka honey. And I feel like the company rights are being violated and the benefit of the Manuka honey is being obscured by nonsense because FDA is really a patsy of the drug company. And if you can go and use Manuka honey instead of a medication for acid reflux that cause other problems or just antibiotic to protect you from infection of a wound, then you are ruining their business. But this is a violation of the antitrust law. Not only that, it's a violation of the public right, the people right to choose what they want. If they want Manuka honey instead of a drug, if they want Manuka honey instead of an antibiotic, they have all the rights to do it. And they have all the rights to be properly informed. So by having FDA stepping in and saying, no, you cannot say that. It doesn't matter. That is the truth. You cannot say that because otherwise it becomes a drug and you haven't done the testing. Well, first of all, most of the drug out there haven't done the proper testing. And they're putting them on the market and wait and see. If it does damage, well, then they'll issue warning. So most of them do not have any proper testing. Even though the company claimed they did, they didn't. And FDA knows it. That's why you have the whistleblower FDA, and now they're suing FDA. Those are class action lawsuits. I mean, come on. Everything is upside down. But food cannot be classified as a drug, and that's the same thing they did with us. Say, oh, well, you're using a product to enhance the absorption of the laser light by the tumor. And it doesn't matter that it's a food base. It's totally.
How can you call that medicinal, though, when all it does is a heat, reaction?
You cannot call it medicinal. It's absolutely ridiculous. Oh, but you're using for cancer, so it's a drug. No, that's the use. The drug is used for treating diseases or diagnosing diseases. Used for that. That is not its definition. The definition of a drug is it has to create a transformation, a physiological process alteration in the body, and that could be a beneficial change. Could. It could also be bad. But a physical change like absorbing light, it's not a physiological change. Therefore, it's not a drug. And it is obvious, but they finagle the statements hoping you'll believe it, you will buy it, and then they got you trapped. And that's why I'm saying, no, fight back. That's what I said to Diamond Food, fight back. And this is the reason why. Do it. Your attorneys obviously don't know anything, but have them use this. Don't agree to anything. Do not stop making those statements on your website. And now what did they do? They turn around and they're doing it with the Manuka honey also. And I think all of us should get together and fight back as a group. That's ridiculous. And it's an abuse of people's right. Lying for the convenience of drug companies. Disgusting. And of course, the next thing about lying to the public for the interest of the drug company is the Komen Foundation and what they're telling people. Oh, we're doing great thing for you. We're telling you go for early detection, which means a lot of mammograms, very expensive, and they cause cancer anyway. So there you are. You're trapped in. Oh, but now we have better mammograms, better equipment, because now it can detect it a lot earlier because we use not one type of X-ray, two types. So great. Double dose.
Malarkey.
No. So
I'll say it. I won't play it, but I'll say it.
No, but it's no malarkey. That is lying, open lie to the public. And actually what you are exposed to, double the amount of X-ray. So your chance of getting cancer is double. But instead, and that comes in with the video that came out this week and is now making the rounds in different places. I'm glad because people need to see how ridiculous that is and how these poor women, stupid women, completely brainwashed, agreeing to mutilation totally unnecessary. You think there is no consequence of you not having your breast anymore? Dream on. It's just not. Everything we have has a reason to exist, and it's not just the immediate evident reason that people think of. It's just part of physiology, so you cannot miss any part of your body, just like hysterectomy. You think there are no consequences to it? Yeah, think again.
I got the clip here. Do you want me to?
Yeah, go ahead and play that.
All right.
Imagine and refuse to not be here for my children like my mother wasn't here.
So you had both breasts removed?
I had a lump, and so they weren't sure if I had cancer or not. So I made the choice before even finding out to have both breasts removed.
It wasn't a question mark for me. I have two girls. I'd already had, I had my children, and my mother had a hysterectomy, and I didn't think twice about it. I knew I was going to do that. The tougher decision for me was removing my breasts, but I'm not the kind of person that would leave anything to chance. Well, I mean, I did a lot of research, and actually Jackie and I went through this process together, mm-hmm. and we both did a lot of research. And for myself, I felt comfortable with the doctors that I met with that I was going to be in the best of hands. We're lucky that we're in that position. I know not everybody is in that position.
They were lucky.
What position is that? To have somebody that is a butcher? Okay, first of all, let me point out something. We are not a car. We do not have spare parts. By the way, German cars do not have spare parts either. So, but other cars might, but not German cars. So, if you want to compare.
But they were just a lot more expensive.
It depends on the model. But there are no spare parts in the human body. You need everything there. And medicine, okay. This is the big discussion that I've had before. Medicine is not a science. Medicine is an empirical practice. What does empirical mean? What does that mean? Empirical means that it's only looking at appearances. It's only looking at what they can see. I do this, I see this result. I do that, I see that result. There is no scientific basis for what they do. None whatsoever. There is no theory that it needs to be proven. There is no mathematical confirmation. There is nothing. Just the opinion of somebody puts it out. He looks at the results and say, the results are saying this. That's his personal or her personal interpretation. It has nothing to do with scientific hard science base. So it is not a science. It's based on appearances. Or what they call empirical evidence. Well, empirical is appearance. Appearances are deceiving. And just like they say to Pasteur, it's the same mentality. What do you mean germs? What are germs? We cannot see them. So therefore they don't exist. This is stupid. Germs do not exist because they couldn't see them. Okay? And therefore Pasteur was a quack because he said something that they didn't want to accept for whatever reason. Ego matters mostly. The same thing here. Empirical evidence, this is, we have people with cancer, we can see that there is this gene present. And so the skid marks are there. There is a car accident, there are skid marks. So therefore the skid marks are causing the accident. There was on Marcola, this video done the Health Ranger. produced by the alter ego. And I don't like either one of the two, but the message was correct. Okay, we got another break. I don't know what happened. What do you mean? We just had one and now another one? Okay, we'll continue this issue of the video.
Directed energy weapons giving us a space-time continuum warp, making time compress.
Well, yeah, I guess, but we'll get to that. To that one later. There is also something on that to talk about. We'll get to that one later.
Real Alternative Radio. We are OrionTalkRadio.com.
You're listening to The Medical Conspiracy with Dr. Carpenter. Somebody give me a doctor. Oh, yeah. Somebody give me a doctor. Somebody give me a doctor.
Okay, we are back from the break. And one thing I want to point it out, connected with this video of this pathetic women that they agreed to be butchered and they think it was an intelligent decision. But anyway, connected with that, I must say this is, of course, October, Breast Cancer Month. And I would like you to note, to pay attention to something. For 3 years before this one, it was a nightmare when October came about. You couldn't turn around. Donate, donate, donate. Common Foundation, Common Foundation. This product, pink everywhere, pink balloons. A complete nerve-wracking disaster. And it was really very heavy campaign. This year, there is something going on, but it's not.
I've seen a little.
A little. But nothing like it used to be in the past 3 years. What's the difference between the past 3 years and this year? I'll tell you what the difference is. The past 3 years, 4 years ago, in 2008, Les Medinc put out on the paper in Little Rock that famous ad that created the end of the world. Okay, about the blue sky, this woman driving on the passenger side of the sports car with the top down and she has her hand stretched out. Freedom.
And the sky tinted pink.
Yeah, and blue skies because it's happiness, you know, and then there was Les Medinc logo underneath. Okay, that created the end of the world and caused all the troubles, lawsuits, attacks, insults on the web, and, you know, FDA, and then ended up with the FDA raid. Now, Les Medinc, for all practical purposes, is out of business. So their competition has been eliminated. They don't have to spend all that money in propaganda. They just want to rake in the money, whatever they can. And that's why everything has stepped down. But they still need to do something. And so what they do, they put out this ridiculous video. They take out a patsy, somebody that has no idea two women that have no idea what the heck they're talking about. And they're standing up and saying, "Oh, great, I am so smart. I did research. I researched."
And she's in good hands, remember?
Yeah.
She's in the best hands possible.
Yeah, and she realizes that not everybody is, but she is in great hands by great expert. And see, that's why they had double mastectomy when they had nothing, just they were told they had the gene of breast cancer. Really? Are they sure about that? Are you certain that there is a gene that is responsible? Just because they say that to you, does that make any sense? Is it possible? Maybe, but then if there were a gene that causes breast cancer, would the rate of breast cancer been high for 200-300 years at least?
For sure.
Okay? Not just the last 50, 60 years when the drug companies became more powerful. Come on, use a brain. Oh, I did research and I found the best doctors. And the doctors are so great that they cut off. They decided the best thing for me has to ever make a person a woman be all removed.
My doctors are so great they got me a spot on this fake news program to sing their praises.
Right. And remove both breasts and remove the ovary. That's it. and you think that that has no consequences in your metabolism, in the function of your body, in your health, get real, woman, wake up. And, oh, there is no way I'm not going to be around for my kids. You know what? You just increases the chances 100% of not being around. Even if you did have a gene, and if there was actually a gene that was producing breast cancer, not very likely, scientifically speaking, but they say there is. Okay, they say, have they never been wrong? They've been wrong all the time. But, and just because you have it doesn't mean you're going to get it. There are people that carry of diseases and they never get it. Come on, wake up, woman, women, those two. But they use them because they are so brainwashed that they will say anything in front of the camera, doing anything that the doctor says, tells them to say. Okay? Oh, yeah, it's wonderful. I have been mutilated. In the worst way. Oh, but this is not for everybody because you have to have family support. Yes, you have to have family member that is as dumb as you are. Because it's unbelievable.
Probably a nice compensation, too.
What?
Well, nothing to justify what they did to the women, but, you know, it's possible they could have gotten some compensation out of that, too. To go on national television and do all the PR that they did in that video, you know?
I don't know when that does. I don't know, but when they are that brainwashed, you don't know what to think, okay? They are saying, it's wonderful because I eliminated the chance of dying of breast cancer. No, you haven't, okay? Because what the breast cancer happened. And even if you believe that there is a gene that will cause breast cancer, you know what? Breast cancer is just a type of tissue. Doesn't mean by eliminating the breast, you don't have cancer anymore. You never get the cancer anymore. I've seen plenty that had breast cancer. They had a pretty small lump too. They had the breast removed. And then what happened? The cancer developed on the muscle over the scar. The scar area, so it didn't go anywhere, it didn't metastasize, it happened there. And it was spreading on the muscle. So they removed the entire muscle, and what was left, it was the bone and the skin. And what happened next? It started growing on the bone, at which point they cannot do anything about it, and they send you home and make you comfortable. So having been mutilated doesn't solve anything. If you were going to get cancer. If you don't get it, it's because you wouldn't have gotten it in the first place. That is complete stupidity. How can somebody be that brainwashed? How can somebody have so little self-respect to allow to be mutilated? How? Ignorance. Okay? They did research. What research? They researched the doctors, and they thought they got the best because it's the ones that had the longest resume. The longest curriculum vitae, the ones that have all this report that they never even saw or had no idea who wrote it. It was some graduate student, they just put their signature, they don't even know what's written on it, but it's in their name because that was the major professor.
And so curriculum vitae is not a code name for Lay's Med, Bob, okay? Remember, that's what he said in his blogs. The curriculum vitae is actually a buzzword that Lay's Med is using whenever they post to Barbara Hartwell's blog.
Curriculum vitae?
Yeah, yeah. Because that's Barbara's username in Blogspot, you know, blogger that she uses. Right, and the articles on her website will say, by curriculum vitae. That's just her username. But Bob tried to make up some story that's actually either you or me, trying to pull something funny.
You're right. It's a subject, so.
Okay.
But what I was saying is,
I need to learn how to speak English.
Right, you forgot because of the stress. But, okay, let me clarify. Why some people call it resume, some people call it curriculum? Resume is from an ordinary person with an average, lame, ordinary, non-professional job. A curriculum vitae is somebody, a professional. That's in the professional world, multi-degree person has a curriculum vitae, okay? It means what they've done through their lives. That's what it means. All the things they have accomplished in their lives, okay? That's what it means. why Barbara uses that as a, I don't know, code name in the blog. I don't know. But anyway, that's what it means. It does not mean Liz Medink. Okay, so the problem is that people look at superficial, insignificant details. And they say, this person has a curriculum vitae longer than the other one, so I guess he's a better doctor. So I go and I have the choices of the best doctor. So the best doctor told me that the best thing I could do for myself would be multi-mutilation. And I've been really lucky. I mean, how brainless can you be? And that's why our webmaster decided to put a parallel joke. That's connected with some of the things I've said in the past. In the past, I said, you have something disease, cut off the part. Okay, so does that mean that if you have brain cancer, you cut off the head? And that's why. Okay, we got a break coming up. Okay, we'll continue after.
You're listening to The Medical Conspiracy with Dr. Carpenter.
Hey, and if you're listening again, we do have a chat board. It's at medicalconspiracy.com on the listen page. Listen at the top of the page. Just click it. Go there. Okay.
All right. If you want to say something. And,
as long as you're not a troll.
Yeah. If you're a troll, we're going to get you. no mercy for trolls. Okay. What I was saying, no mercy for stupidity either. What I was saying before the break was again about this ridiculous video. And I can't believe that people can take it seriously. It's just another form of brainwashing. And I already explained that removing the breast does not, and I said that many times, does not stop the occurrences of breast cancer. But by having an hysterectomy, then you have to have hormonal replacement therapy. Otherwise, you're totally messed up. So you get hormonal replacement therapy. Hormonal replacement therapy causes breast cancer. So you're greatly increasing your chance of getting cancer. Why does it cause breast cancer? Because hormonal replacement reactivates something that has been deactivated, and the body function is all messed up, and that creates overgrowth, and that can create breast cancer. But you have had, she has had the breast removed also. Does that stop breast cancer? No, we already told you that. It does not. It can still occur on the muscle tissue and can still occur over the bone. So it's solving nothing, only increasing the chances of getting cancer. Because any medication you take, you increase the chances of getting cancer. Cancer is caused by drugs, legal drugs. Cancer is caused by medication. Do not take them. That's what causes the cancer in the first place. But we are in a society where everything has to be clear in a few days. And drug over drug, give me a pill. I'll pop the pill and I'll be fine. Well, you might appear to be fine right off at first, but what are the long-term effects? And that's what you have to worry about, the long-term effects. And cancer are one of the long-term effects. That just happens all the time. Like, okay, another great thing I read an article that states that statin drugs decrease the risk of glaucoma. And I think that another drug that is connected, what is that? It's another drug that is connected with, it's an expensive drug taken for diabetes, and actually is another cause. They say if you take that drug, you are going to stop breast cancer. Okay? Metformin. And is an expensive, supposedly inexpensive drug used for diabetes. Well, if you use it, they say it can may fight breast cancer. Okay, so you're trying to fight breast cancer. You take these inexpensive drugs, and what you're getting, the problem of drugs for diabetes are that they give you a heart attack.
Nice.
And in this particular case, metformin causes liver and kidney shutdown. Okay, but you're helping breast cancer. And with the statin drugs, it said decreases the risk of the glaucoma. Okay? But of course, the statin drugs cause, what do they cause? Liver damage. Okay, so you are countering one problem and introducing a bigger problem than one you had to start with. Okay? That's what happens with anything. Because the drugs are tested for one thing and one thing only. They do not test them for long-term effect in other parts of the body. So they make you believe that the other problems you develop is because of you, your system. And you would have developed anyway sooner or later, in this case later. It's not what they gave you that caused. They're never going to admit to that.
And genes.
Yeah, I know. And that is really... Okay, but they have these wonderful videos that tell you how happy these people are. Oh, I was multi-mutilation. I am doing great. Really? Yeah, sure. So I start thinking about it. Did they really? They might even have been actors. I don't know. But they accuse us of people that praise our treatment are lying, and they are pretending and misinforming. Hey, they have test evidence.
Those ladies in that video, shills. That is the definition of the word shill right there in that video.
Oh, the greatest help, and not everybody has it.
Well, you know, I've seen some people, you know, that aren't too fond of you refer to you as a shill. You know, and it's like, no, you don't even know what a shill is. This is a shill in this video here. Yeah, get your body parts cut off. And thanks, John, by the way, John Connor. He made a second version of that graphic and brought some traffic to it.
But you made the one about the brain, didn't you?
Yeah. Well, they were both about they were both telling the same joke, basically. I got the gene for brain cancer, so I'm going to have a preventative brain removal. You know, I mean, it's a no-brainer. Not going to take any chances.
Anybody that believes that, I guarantee you, doesn't have a brain to start with. So, what are you removing? Something that is not there? I mean, there are some people that when the brains were passed out, they were absent. And it shows, either that or they...
Oh, I know what it... Yeah, that you thought they said train, so you ran to the other direction. When they were passing out brains, you thought they said rain, so you ran for cover. Yeah. There's an old joke from elementary school.
Oh, really? I don't know, but it's unbelievable. Okay, now somebody... be actually on the level, so say something that's stupid. I have no idea. Now, on the subject of lack of brain, I try to be not too harsh on this, but it's sure hitting my weak points right there. This week, as I said, several things happened. This video was really just happened. It's pathetic. But the other thing that happened was we were contacted by a British talk show host saying that he wanted to do his review of the medical, of if actually a medical conspiracy exists. And so basically, I guess he was looking for a debate between us and some real medical expert. Okay? member of the medical establishment to determine if a medical conspiracy actually exists.
Maybe we could find Dr. Pompous Peacock. Bring him in.
Okay. Now, let me ask you something. As a parallel example, 9/11, okay? Did 9/11 actually happen as it was presented, or is it a conspiracy? Was a conspiracy. We are trying to find out if 9/11 was a conspiracy or not. So what are we going to do? We are going to call member of the Homeland Security.
Dick Cheney, maybe. Yeah, he'll tell you the truth.
Right. So, but if you don't want to go that high, it might be too important to come to a radio show. Let's call members of the Homeland Security and bring them in, interview them, and ask them, was there a conspiracy? Was there a conspiracy by the government to create Homeland Security?
Well, see, I don't know, because Homeland Security wasn't created until after 9/11, you know. All part of the plan, you see.
Right. So, are you going to ask the Mafia if Mafia exists? For years, Mafia, till it was obviously proven that Mafia existed, for years, Mafioso claimed, that's a nonsense. Mafia, what is that? I never heard of it. Mafia does not exist. That is just a figment of imagination. It's an excuse to attack the Italians, southern Italians, of course. And only in recent time that has been proven that they obviously exist and have been operating for years and years, then there was no longer an issue. But when you ask the Mafia, they said, no, Mafia does not exist. What is Mafia? Never heard of it. And so Homeland Security, they're going to tell you 9/11 was a fake. It was made happen. Our government was in it. You think Homeland Security will admit to that? Of course not.
Sure they will.
Yeah, right. On what planet? And so what you're saying, I'm going to call members of the AMA, which they are the expert, and especially the one with the longest CVs. Call those. The better. Oh, call people at MD Anderson. Ask him, is it really a medical conspiracy? Did you really kill this person that was cured of melanoma by Lismed Inc.? They're going to say, oh, yeah, we did that. Uh-huh.
Find a 33rd degree Mason. Ask him what the pyramid really means. I'm sure they'll tell you the truth.
Okay, but that's not a crime. I'm talking about real crime committed. Well, they're going to admit to crimes. I don't think so. Are we kidding? Oh,
Wow,
that came really fast.
Slipped up.
Okay, we're going to finish this up during the second hour. Okay, we'll be back soon after the news.
Don't touch that mouse. The medical conspiracy will return in just a moment. Welcome to The Medical Conspiracy with Dr. Carpenter.
Okay, we're now back for the second hour after the news.
Hey, can I butt in real quick?
I don't know about that.
Real quick. if you're listening on Shoutcast or anywhere else, actually, live, we have a chat room. Actually, have a few people here. Dingo Foxman and some anonymous people that don't want to be named. I'm not going to say anything, okay? I'm not saying they're trolls. And not saying you're not trolls, okay? Glad you're here. But if you go to medicalconspiracy.com and look for the listen button on the menu, just click it and come on down. Okay, sorry. Just wanted to get that in.
Okay. If you're a troll, go away. Okay, the world has enough problems as it is. You don't need to join in and upset people anymore. Okay, with that, going back to what we were saying before the end of the first hour, and I was saying you can't ask a member of a conspiracy, of a conspiring organization, you cannot ask him, oh, our suspicion of a conspiracy, are they correct? Gee, are you going to ask a murderer if they have murdered people? Very rarely they admit to it, if any. So they're all innocent, okay? And it's just the same thing. You don't do that. How do you prove there is a conspiracy? Very easy. Do not ask the member of the conspiracy. If there is one, you're going to get a ridiculous answer. You prove it. You prove it. You provide evidence that it exists. Okay, and how do you provide evidence? Show their lies. Show what they're saying that doesn't correspond to truth. And how do we prove about the medical conspiracy? Because it's not true. Everything they tell you, oh, we have wonderful drugs that they, breast cancer is being resolved. How? By poisoning you to death? Oh, but now you last longer. And now we can mutilate you early so you can survive. And they don't. People don't. They subject themselves to that terrible humiliation, suffering, discomfort, the terrible life afterward. Oh, but there is a foundation that is saying life after breast cancer, and they can help you. Really? What help is that? Okay. So that's the first brainwashing of the public, which is the first thing that will make you suspicious, because the story they tell you does not correspond to what you see around you. So that's the first point that is unclear. Now, let's go to the other point, and now that we introduce the fact that it is a conspiracy. If it weren't a conspiracy, and if they were not sure, if they were really sure, not just simply suspected, they were sure that our method did not work and what we were saying was not correct, then why wouldn't they agree to the challenge I offered? I said, okay, you're saying that wireless meeting toss doesn't work. You're saying that you're telling the truth to the people, that there is no cure for cancer. You cannot resolve the cancer. That you are correct and what we do is nonsense. Really? Prove it. And that's what we say. Okay, put your money where your mouth is and do the proper testing. And this
put your
is
duct tape where your mouth is.
No, they want to put duct tape on my mouth. They want to put duct tape on my mouth, not theirs, okay? So that's what's going on. They say, oh, no, what Liz Meeting did does not work because we said so. And because it needs more testing, and we're doing it, and the university are struggling with this, and they still cannot find the right results, and they cannot find the right way to do it. Yeah, they cannot find a way to copy because they don't want it.
They got a whole research department that has to make a living.
Yeah. So, for years to come, doesn't matter how many people die in the meantime. I put out a video that has been greatly criticized. It was called Put Up or Shut Up. And I said...
Yeah.
I said, do the testing. And this is the testing. Not because I said so, but because the science that said so. When you're talking about hyperthermia, the type of testing is different. Besides, the type of testing they do after standard treatment is also another fraud. It's a fraud because they give you a treatment that suppresses the immune system. Chemo radiation suppress the immune system, okay? And then what they do a testing that looks at immune activity. That's what a PET scan is. That's what MRI is. They do that type of testing and tell you, oh, man, there is a lot of activity. You still have cancer. Oh, after chemo radiation, there is no activity whatsoever. You're fine. No, you're not fine. Your immune system has been suppressed. They can't see anything. There is nothing left to see. But as soon as your body recovers, there you go. Oh, but this is a reoccurrence. We saved it. We fixed it. But now it's a reoccurrence. I mean, that's the biggest farce. But with hyperthermia, of course, you have the opposite situation. During the healing, after the treatment, during the healing, you have a lot of immune activity because the body is removing the dead tissue. Now, what they're saying is, no, it's not true. It's activity of the cancer. And what we say is do the right testing. And this is the right testing. Get a sample, use an electron microscope, or use a CT scan with contrast, or an ultrasound with color Doppler that tell you no blood flow in it, or do testing of the tissue and use a special stain that will tell you that only is absorbed by that tissue. So there are many ways that you can show that the tissue is dead. Are they doing it? No, they refuse to do it. We said that what you do doesn't work. That's it. End of the story. They did not take up this challenge, and what did they do? They got us raided. With that, on the false pretenses, by the way, not for the reason that they were attacking us for, because there was nothing that we had been doing that was anything that would require a raid by FDA. It was total abuse.
And the COINTEL had everything to do with it, though, you know.
Yeah.
One particular COINTEL named Michelle was all over the blogosphere and all over the internet and saying over and over, you know, approaching strangers even and saying, you need to contact the FDA, you need to contact the authorities, all this. And what happened when the FDA showed up and you finally got to see their paperwork? Verbatim quotes out of this COINTEL, I'm not even going to say the word on the air, but you know what I'm thinking, mouth.
Yes, no, that was not written. That was in words, but written down was that we were
selling false hope.
No, but in the paper, the one that the judge read, was said that we were distributing adulterated drugs and adulterated medical equipment. That has nothing to do with what we were doing. So they had to lie to even get a court order to raid us.
Sure they did.
Okay. So isn't that a proof of a conspiracy? Because if what we were doing was wrong, why won't they say the truth in the affidavit? They didn't.
We got two years worth of archive shows on the medicalconspiracy.com that were going on while the fake trial was going on, and you want to find proof of a conspiracy, listen to some of those. I mean,
it's there.
Goes way back.
And that's how you prove a conspiracy, not asking the AMA, is there a conspiracy? Or ask the drug companies, are you paying off doctors to sell your drugs? Are you giving them money under the table? Are you giving them not just perks, they're giving them money. Are you? They're going to tell you, yes, we are. Oh, yeah.
Ask my neighbors. Yeah. Go ask my neighbors. Ask them if there's a conspiracy going on.
Oh, no. They're going after somebody that is really hurting people, because curing people of cancer is hurting them, you see? Then they cannot have all those wonderful drugs and all those wonderful mutilation. So it's a crime. I mean, it's just unbelievable. But there you have it. It's the proof there is a conspiracy. And it's just not for cancer. It's anything that the medical establishment handles. I mean, there are, and get this, okay? If you read, I get emails about this. I don't know if you do, but I got emails. Oh, did you use this drug? Okay, the last two, did you use antidepressant? Is that a break?
I think so. We're coming to a break.
We're back from the break. And before the break, I was trying to present to you how you can figure out it's a conspiracy, not by asking the medical or the drug companies, are you really running a conspiracy against anything that can cure cancer? Because the facts are there. The evidence is there. If you're attacking, why are they not attacking the, some of the nonsense that alternative practitioners use? They're not attacking them. Like, all of a sudden, everybody's talking about the Black Sabbath. The Black Sabbath is horrible. And it used to be illegal. I don't know what happened. I tell you what happened. Some of the alternative practitioners using Black Sabbath have helped FDA railroad us. And so they're leaving them alone. So now everybody's talking about it. Oh, the Black Sabbath. Sure, as I said, get Drano and put it on. Or drink it. It's the same thing. It's unbelievable. But the evidence is there. Plus, let me tell you, there is no minor amount of money they spent on this. Because after the monkey trial that we had, illegal, unconstitutional, violating every right of a human in this country possible, they got away with that. And then they were trying to get FDA to come in and take away my means of making money because the trial was not enough. But that went on for months because this name of this supposed patient that they were trying to schedule for treatment had been going on for months. And then cancel, not show up, cancel the appointment, and rechange the appointment because they couldn't get an affidavit, the affidavit to produce a warrant from the judge because of the excuses they were putting there until they finally they came up with blatant lies until they could get a
retail store.
Yeah, they could get a warrant. They made it look like I was running a meth lab.
Your and clinic then, was a retail store, though. See, I never knew that.
Yeah, I didn't either.
Retail store called Lays Med Inc.
Yeah. I don't know where the laser comes into selling drugs, but anyway. So, yeah. They had to change the story, obviously, several times. That's why they made an appointment in the council, made another appointment in council, and this went on for months. And then, of course, they start to get desperate when their videos were starting showing up on YouTube with me presenting hard evidence of the lies they had been working with. So they had to do something, and then they came up with the biggest lie. And that probably is that's a brainchild of Jeremy, right?
Mm-hmm. Good old Jeremy.
Yeah. So, I mean, are you going to do it?
Oh, I never. We talked about it. I never actually did it.
Okay.
I may still in the future. Yeah, I was thinking about getting a few bars of Pearl Jam and throwing it in there, but.
But anyway, yeah. I mean, that might be, and maybe he's being compensated for being so great in his lies. So I don't know. That's Jeremy coming up with this. But think about the money that would have cost. And of course, some people got great compensation from drug companies because those are the ones to profit from. The AMA and the drug company profit from putting Liz Med Inc. out of business. Think about it. Such a small company like Liz Med Inc. and they created such a ruckus and they had all these activities and all this money spent at trying to ruin a small company, a really small company. Why? Think about it. It had to be that they knew perfectly well that what we did was working. They knew perfectly well.
You were completely outside of the box from most of the other alternatives, the other, you know, cancer alternatives.
I still am because I don't agree with all the things they do. They're terrible. They make the situation worse. That's why they leave most of them alone. Because they make the situation worse, and in the end, the patient desperate goes back and agrees to mutilation, chemo, and radiation. That's why it's okay. And they usually die because it's too far gone. Well, they die anyway, even if it's not far gone, because standard treatment is poisoning a person. So that's a proof of conspiracy. All the details, all the facts, all the evidence is there. So how come people don't realize what happened and start having a fit over it? And, of course, our webmaster got mad and said people will jump on Mickey Mouse a Minnie Mouse being messed up. And I agree with that. Minnie Mouse should be left alone.
Yeah, I was wrong about, you know, redrawing Minnie Mouse to look all tall and skinny and wafy looking, you know.
No, not skinny, because she is skinny. Minnie Mouse is skinny. I mean, making her look anorexic, that's a totally different thing.
Well, that's why I said wafy, you know. It looks like a waif wasted away. But, you know, it also goes back to, I remember when I was a kid in the 70s, Mickey Mouse. Okay, this is Minnie Mouse, but anything insignificant and overblown that's really trivial, you'd say, oh, that Mickey Mouse article or all that Mickey Mouse TV show. But the fact that a petition on change.org having to do with Minnie Mouse and the way she was depicted got 60,000, and I'm sure it's probably close to 70,000 now, signatures for a cartoon character, and that your petition... To try to petition the FDA to think about what they've done and just to garner support. You know, this is for a treatment that is a safe and effective alternative to chemo and radiation. And you're a real person, not a cartoon character.
And it's not an alternative. It's a solution to cancer and without any suffering, without any torture, without any mutilation. So... Yeah, I know, but...
Just the numbers, that's all. It was just comparing the numbers as being sort of a insult.
But I still think they should leave Minnie Mouse alone. And you see, that's a bad propaganda, making these kids think that they're looking like a walking skeleton is good, is healthy. Just like not eating anything is healthy. Oh, take your vitamins, you're fine. You don't have to eat. Or don't eat real food. Or be a vegan. Yeah, right. That's the best way to get sick for the rest of your life, whatever life that might be. I mean, it's just unbelievable, but that's what's happening. And the other thing, and the other side, a dredger side of the industry is, they're in it, the two things, the medical and the legal. And you think they're enemy, actually they're feeding one another. Look at what's happening out there. I don't know if you do, but I do get email all the time, as I started saying earlier, saying, have you been using antidepressant? Oh, these are the side effects. Did you use antidepressant when you were pregnant and you had a child with birth defect? Or did you use antidepressant and had this and that other problem? Well, there is a class action lawsuit going on, and this is the law firm to contact them and see. Now there is another one. This is not cancer either, but it's still medical and surgery. This is about the surgical mesh. And apparently falls apart after surgery, a while after surgery. And then you have problems because the surgical mesh is holding something in place that is otherwise not falling apart in the surgery, and then people have problem with their internal organ because of the mess they made, so they put a surgical mesh to keep things in place, and then of course that falls apart and then they run into trouble. But it's okay, no problem, because there is a legal firm that is doing a class lawsuit against this, and so you're gonna get money. Actually, the one that makes the most amount of money in a class action lawsuit is the legal. Okay, we got a break coming up.
Free speech guaranteed. You're listening to the Orion Talk Radio Network.
Chip bag.
You do?
Or something.
Well, there is a little mouse here that got hungry, and I don't think it's Minnie Mouse, but...
Hey, I want to say hi to Dingo Foxman in the chat room. He just signed your petition, he said.
Oh, thank you.
Thanks, Dingo. Appreciate it.
Okay. I think that I have explained enough why there is a conspiracy, and I have provided enough evidence. But if people out there don't think so, please let me know. Send us an email and ask us to give more details, what else they want to know, to prove that it is a conspiracy. It is a conspiracy from putting Lesmed Inc. out of business and keeping people with no choices, no alternatives, no way to treat cancer in a humane, simple, rather inexpensive way. And of course, if insurance companies were covering it, would really be extremely inexpensive. Your deductible might end up really a few hundred dollars, that's all. That would be something. Anyway, and it should be that way. Okay, the other thing that I was wanting to discuss was a few weeks ago, maybe a couple of weeks ago, I don't remember, something down that line, I put out on WordPress a new blog. And the reason, actually, there were two on the same subject. And the reason why I wanted to put them out is because my life is all on science and the importance and validity of science. So a lot of people have mixed feeling on the subject. They really don't believe it's that important. They also, as I said, believe that medicine is a science, which isn't. And so I put out this post that is this blog with the title of In Defense of Science. And I'm trying to point out how important science is, real science is, in everyday life. It's everywhere.
Well, even if you look at the cancer hospital that started all this mess against you back in Arkansas, what are they called? University of Arkansas for Medical Sciences.
Okay, but it's not.
The word, they even used the word there in their name.
Yeah, I know they use the word, but it's misusing the word. Science is something that is based on solid theory, proven, mathematically proven, confirmed, and then utilizing different branches, but it always has not an empirical. The empirical side is only a confirmation. It's not the basis. So anything that is only relying on empirical appearances, basically, is not a science because appearances are deceiving. But anyway, so I put this blog in defense of science, and somebody picked it up and reposted on their website. And that's nice. I thank the person that did that. The problem is that the comment on that was that I was basically wrong because science is our enemy. See, that's not so at all. That's
what it says, I hope she's not laboring under the misapprehension that science is her friend. Or something like that, yeah.
Science is everybody's friend. First of all, let me explain something. There are no science advancement. Science has always existed. It's something separate from human life. It exists as a truth that has always been there, and it'll always be there, okay? That's why we used in our website the music... Thus spoke Zarathustra, because the philosophy of Zarathustra was relying on that thought, that science has always existed. Human understanding of science has progressed over the years. There are now new discoveries. The science has always been there. That is an independent reality, is an objective, is a fact. The human understanding of science has increased over the years. And from that, of course, has become technology is an offspring of science. You develop technology based on science. So saying science and technology, no. Science is something that has always been there and human have understood very little over the centuries, millennia, and then the understanding has slowly increased over time and things are improving because people understand science better. Science explains what happened out there. And as I said in the blog, science will make you understand and free you of fear. If you know science, you won't be afraid because you know what causes everything. You need know the connecting lines and you can know what to do and not to do. Science is your guide. Now, technology is derived from science. And even technology in there is not your enemy. It's the humanity, is the human factor, what humans do with science and the knowledge of science and the technology they develop. What they do to the technology they develop that could be not your friend. It's the human factor that is not your friend, not the science, not the technology developed from it. Okay? It's just like saying the gun is guilty. Somebody gets killed with a gun, therefore the gun is guilty. No, it's the use the human make of that gun. It's not the proper use of it, and that is what's wrong. It's the human factor that is at fault. Human can be good or bad, can you be your friend or your enemy, but it's the human, not the thing, and certainly not the science.
Hey, you know that I've had an itchy trigger finger today, so speaking of science...
Okay.
It's not about me. It's about
science. This is a new way of
taking content.
Science.
No, we can't be done.
It's about science.
It is a mind blower. It's just basically an electric field. The whole discussion of the content.
Okay.
We haven't played that in a long, long time.
It has been a while.
Yeah, we haven't played that in a long, long time. And it was about, yes, what Liz Medin did.
Featuring Joyce Riley.
Yeah, from the... yeah, that's before...
It is a mind blower.
Yeah, but that's before everybody realized that besides standard medicine, but even alternative methods to handle cancer are not... they cannot go along with our treatment. They create problems to the patient.
You know the who else is... I'm sorry, go ahead.
No, go ahead.
You know who else's voice is mixed in there?
Yes, I know, and we're not going to press... discuss.
Yeah.
The voice that says Liz Medin. We're not going to discuss that. That's why I wanted to change that, but we can't.
Oh, well.
Okay. Oh, well. That's the way it goes. Good with the bad comes along with the good sometimes. But what I'm saying is the science is the answer. If you have the facts of science in place, then what you do is valid. But if you have something that has no science background, it's just because I observed this happening, so therefore this is it. No, that's not it. And that's happened with a lot of alternative methods. Oh, we use the black salve, and we've seen that the black salve makes the tumor fall off. It makes tissue fall off, okay? And it creates a whole lot of other problems. And at the same time, it's the same thing. Do you know what the science behind chemo is? The science behind chemo is that we poison your body, all of it, hoping that the cancer will die faster than the rest of you. So... the cancer will die before you do. That's what the hope is. It's a hope.
A lot of people do know that much, though, because I see a lot of that in just the alternative groups on Facebook, even.
Yeah, but in alternative groups, they do not realize that boosting the immune system only does it makes the cancer feel better. You might think you're feeling better, but the cancer is still there, and it feels just as good as you do. And it's growing. And oh, man. Already? Oh.
Wow. We'll be right back.
listening to The Medical Conspiracy with Dr. Carpenter.
Okay, we're back from the break, and apparently a talk show host that reposted the video about the double mastectomy issue, and then I think he reposted some other video of his and the one of our webmaster about the brain cancer. So he saw our message on the board, and he's back. He's on. Hi, John.
Hey, how's it going? It's John from Canada Live here on OrionTalkRadio.com. John, and I just had to share that link. The women having their breasts and ovaries, you know, uterus removed, that don't even have cancer. It's just a preventative measure because they think that there's, you know, some weird thought process where they may have some type of gene or something, and they could get cancer in the future, so they're going to cut off their body parts. And I just have this picture of that TV show Futurama, where it's that cartoon where they have, like, in the future there's people that are just heads in a jar.
Oh yeah,
and that'll be the future cancer, the cure for cancer. Just people, heads in a jar. They just remove the whole body.
Good Lord. But
and then
if you have brain cancer,
and then they have brain cancer, and that's the end of it.
Yeah. Well, you could do what Randy said. What Randy was saying is have the brain removed.
Yeah, off with the head.
Let's have your consciousness downloaded to a chip. That's what it'll come to. Transhumanism, you know.
Well, I don't think it come to it, but I mean, that shows the stupidity of that statement. Oh, I had my breast removed, so I won't get breast cancer. I had my ovary removed, so I won't have ovarian cancer. Please.
But if you want to talk about eugenics, though, think about the mentality that could lead to. Now you've got people convinced that there's a gene, you know, that's linked to certain kinds of cancer. Let that keep going, extrapolate, eventually be having engineered babies that, we engineered them to not have that gene anymore, and eventually you're...
Okay, but that the gene, it says that you could. It doesn't say that you will.
Exactly. And this gene is something that no one can see with their naked eye. And they're going to say, well, you got this thing that nobody can see with the naked eye, and maybe it could lead to cancer in the future, so we're going to chop off your body parts. How does that sound? Oh, thanks for saving me.
Yeah, right. That's
what they're
saying.
It's pretty creepy.
I don't like the naked eye thing, because then that falls back into attacking Pasteur, because it said germs. Well, we cannot see germs, so they don't exist. I'm not saying that it doesn't exist. It could exist, a gene that will give you tendency, not certainty, okay?
Right.
It can give you a possibility, a tendency maybe of getting breast cancer. But the problem is that is the doctor that tells you, you cannot verify it. And unfortunately for the people that are victim of this, they have to trust the doctors. That's their problem. You can't, because they tend to make so much money out of it that you shouldn't trust them. Would you trust a used car salesman? No, this is not any different. You
and
think it is, but it isn't.
What's messed up is that was on CNN on a show called Dr. Drew. And there was two women there. And I think one of the women said she's a nurse or something.
Yeah.
So this woman's a nurse and was talked into having her breast removed and her ovaries removed. And she doesn't have cancer. And I mean, so the level of brainwashing to me is through the roof, because it's not like somebody off the street that they just try to con. It's somebody in the medical profession who conned into this.
The reason why they do that is because the nurses see the horror of the cancer treatment and they make them terrified. Okay. So they stop thinking. They stop thinking. That is the real problem. Okay. People are overpowered by fear. And a nurse that works in the hospital, she sees what they do to people with cancer. So that obviously terrifies her. And she's not even stopping to think if it makes sense what the doctors are saying. And they rush for some extreme cases. They should know that breasts are not just... they don't just have one purpose. Nothing in the body has just one purpose. And it is just not something that you use for a short time in your life and then that's the end of it. So you don't need a breast remover or the ovary, you don't need them anymore, breast remover, because they're responsible for a lot of things and mess up your metabolism. Wake up, people. And then, of course, you have to take this medication to replace what you have removed. And those are the ones that cause cancer. So you're not resolving anything. You're making a situation worse under the fear that it could possibly happen. Well, we could possibly walk out and go by a building and piano could fall off the window and splash you against the concrete, okay? That could happen. It could happen. You know, Judy Tenuta, it could happen. Remember that?
Well, I cut the back of our house off where there's a kitchen, little add-on that's a kitchen on there. I was thinking of just cutting it right off because it could get moldy in the future.
Good idea.
It could have some mold and some rot and maybe some ants, carpenter ants get in there. So we'll just cut the whole thing off and just...
Or it could burn because there is a kitchen there.
Exactly. Yeah.
It could burn and then burn the whole house. So you have to have it removed.
It's just ludicrous, the logic in this. And what blows my mind is it's on mainstream television, on CNN, and people are watching this and it doesn't faze them.
I don't understand that. And another thing,
switch it over with Jerry Springer. It's a little more interesting. Yeah.
They had this article that referred to something that was presented months ago. And they say, this article was saying the cure for cancer is here now in this month, October month. And they say the cure of cancer is here because they have done research on leukemia. Okay. And what they use is what they call killer cells. And the killer cells attack the cancer and kill the cancer. And that's it, you're cured. Now, these killer cells, what are they? Is actually they inject AIDS in the patient. Oh, but this is a benign strain of AIDS. What?
Okay.
Yeah, a benign strain of AIDS, they inject into the patient and it kills, eliminates leukemia. And they tested it. And they were successful in two cases, actually two and a half cases. And the half being somebody that only was, I don't even know if it was in remission, but it stopped the spreading of the leukemia temporarily. We don't know what's going to happen next. And so there are two and a half cases of success. So the future is we got the cure for cancer. Now, mind you, is injecting a person with AIDS, but it's a safe string of AIDS. And that would only work for leukemia anyway. It wouldn't work for tumors. But they're screaming success with 2.5 cases that were helped. How many did they test? They didn't say. 2.5 cases, okay? I mean, Lasmedink had a lot more than that. A lot more than 2.5. No, that's not true. The patients are delusional. Okay? This is what happens. And how can people buy that? 2.5 cases? What does that mean?
I don't know. I was going to go get both my feet removed to the preventative measure to stop any type of, you know, foot cancer. And also, it's a double-edged sword because I can also save tax money by reducing my carbon footprint.
Carbon tax.
So there you go. It's a double header. Why not? Everyone should be going to do it.
Man, that's
well, of course, that doesn't help because you have to use the car more, so you use more gas. So that is not necessarily a carbon emission limitation. Because you can't walk, so...
Yeah, but I reduce the footprint, right? That's the whole gag.
Right. So... As I said, you're afraid of brain cancer. You had the head removed, so you won't think. And thinking is dangerous.
Of course it is nowadays.
Oh, yeah. Well, the Catholic Church has always said that thinking is dangerous. That goes way back. See, before I left Italy, when I was getting ready to marry my first husband, he was in the military. We had all sorts of paperwork to fill, and he was the U.S. Army, so, and I was in Italy, so we had all sorts of paperwork before I could leave Italy, go to Vietnam where he was, and get married there. It was easier than do it any other way. But I had to have all sorts of paperwork from the Catholic Church because he was also Catholic, and so we got married. We were married by a Catholic chaplain who was a great guy, by the way, really funny. But I had to go through all of these things. So against my principle of going to church, I had to go to see the priest, and I had to wait that he was finished with the mass until I got to talk to him. So I was there listening to the nonsense he was preaching. And one of the things he said was that what is really not good for people to get too much of an education. Studying too much is not good for you. Okay, getting a lot of degrees, a good degrees, no, that is not good for you. What he was saying is it's not good for the Catholic Church because then you start thinking too much and then it becomes dangerous because you can see what we say and the trick they're trying to pull, it becomes transparent, okay? So education, thinking, and knowledge is not good for you because then you cannot be enslaved, okay? So might as well take off the head, right? Off with the head.
Well, those million dead Iraqis, we didn't go after them for the weapons of mass destruction. It was to go prevent cancer in Iraq.
I guess.
Except for the people that got tumors from the depleted uranium, aside from them.
Well, our soldiers got that too. And then they...
With Dr. Carpenter.
Wow.
There's the end.
Wow, 2 hours.